And now to share with you the much awaited ombre. You got it. Green. I saw this reviewed and decided I had to have it. Again, I ordered this from Wig Types. And so it's packaged very nicely. And I just can't maneuver it with one hand. So I will get back to you once I get it out of the package. When you first take it out of the bag, you want to scream. You want to go, oh my God, this is not what I saw on the video. It's coarse to the point of almost being like too coarse. And I just like, I'm screaming the way my mother did when I told her I was going to get it. But I have high hopes for this unit because I saw the reviews and I fell in love. It has drawstrings in the back, two, and no combs. And this is a wig. It is not a lace front. So it's going to be challenging for a person without a hairline, even though I did notice the models that did the reviews on it did not have their own hair out or even attempt to mix it in with this unit. I love the fact that it does have the coarseness. It actually looks like human hair. And it is a fauteur and it does take heat. It's a Janet collection, so I'm anticipating the cap being spacious. Look at those beautiful colors. The greens and the purple and the... Oh, this is just so pretty. This is hopefully my opera hair. I really got high hopes for it. This right here is kind of cute. It pulls out to like a little Betty Boop right there. And this little curl right here. One of the models had to cut that off. It just wasn't behaving. Mine seems to go down, perhaps like it's supposed to. The hairline on it is really cute because of this right here. This is always a problem when you've got the short units. I remember the Euro that came out a few years ago. It just had that blunt stop right there. So if you didn't have a hairline, you just couldn't do anything with it. If I was going to really go for it, I could do a bunch of little Betty Boop curls right here and it would just look adorable. That's the start of it. So let's see. Let's start and put the brush to this thing and see what happens, okay? We've got this going. And let's see. I'm going to play with it. I'm going to play with it off camera because I can't do both. I can't hold the phone and play with the hair. All right. Had to show you what I'm doing so far. I went in and I pulled it up. I don't know what the back is looking like because I can't see back there. But I'll see it once I do the video. I didn't know that. I was brushing it down into like a finger wave, which never works for me. And then I decided to brush it upward. And what happened was I got this mommy wig effect where it started to curl up for me. And I really like that. I like the fact that I could curl it up. That is so cute. And then brush it smooth along the side. So that's where I am in my playing so far. And I like it. I haven't put any water on it or moisturizer on it, so I'm sure that'll make it curl even better. But for now, and this is not a human hair unit. This is amazing. It's got a big cap, really spacious cap. So big head girls like me, let's carry on. Okay, so I did all I can do for now, but I love the curls that came up on the side, like the way the mommy wig reacts to water. I had no water, no moisturizer, so it's a little dry. I probably would moisturize it if I was going to wear it out, give it more of a sheen, but I just went up with my fingers and it went right up. I'm almost scared to touch it again. So cute. And I didn't have trouble with the little doomy flotchy here on the side. I just pulled it down and mine behaved. And then this little curly stuff here, I think I would play with it and get it a little curlier. The bang didn't dip low like I thought it would, but that's fine. Once again, I don't want it in my eye. I probably would try to work it down a little bit lower, but that's about it. I wouldn't really concern myself with it that much. It's not that big a deal. Maybe on camera it looks a little funky, but off camera it looks just fine. The colors are gorgeous. Of course, I love this green ombre thing. And then I think I did a good job of circling the hair in back underneath the set of curls that I created on that side. It's very tapered at the neck. Hopefully you can see that. Because again, I'm working off my phone, so I hope you can see the curls. It's just cute. It actually is something that I could wear anywhere. It's not as glamorous as I thought, like, oh, it's going to have so much green. I will not be able to wear this anywhere but the opera or somewhere dramatic. Mm-mm. It's just really nice. The highlights in it are so stinking cute that I actually could wear it anywhere. And because it takes heat and it's so malleable, you can bring your bangs down and cover some more forehead. If you feel you have a large forehead and you want to cover more, just bring it down and move it. I love it. It is like the Euro wig in that you don't, you know, you just can move a lot of the curls with your hand. I don't know if they'll give out in time, but for now they really do exactly what you want. The hair is very coarse and natural looking to me. I like that. And you just put those curls where you want them and they go where you want them. It's got a real human-esque looking look to it, like you permed your own hair and added some color to it. Again, I'm just really digging these curls back here. They're just so adorable. I had no idea that the piece did that. So, ladies who bought it, if you haven't tried putting your curls in there, that's so cute. I love that because the finger wave in me, it doesn't work. My head is too oddly shaped to... That finger wave looks really strange, and I kind of worried about that with this unit, and now the worry is totally gone. This is so kinky up here. I could actually curl that up and make it like a, you know, like a really curly thing if I wanted to. You know, I could make it super curly, just like bubbly curly. Or I could put it back like I had it. Hope I didn't mess it up. I didn't mess it up. Just have to play with it again and get it back like I had it. But anyway, and keep the green on the green side and keep the dark on the dark side. But none of that worried about the parting here. I don't have to worry about that. It sits on my forehead very nicely. So this is just a really, turned out to be a really quick review. Look at that. That's so pretty. And they stay. They stay where you put them because the hair is so dense. It's very thick and very dense. So yeah, I love it. Now I'm going to go back and get a gold one. And I'm going to go back and get a burgundy one because these are gorgeous. And I hope my other ones are of the same quality. Again, I got these from Wig Types. Wig Types. And I don't know. I think all the wigs are the same no matter which company you really order them from. I mean, I've heard that they could be different. But in my case, I got, you know, I think each wig is a little different. Like I've seen some with this curl doing some really crazy things and it's having to be cut off. Whereas for me, it's laying down very nicely. I guess because I don't mind having a sideburn. You know, because my head is the size it is or the shape it is, a sideburn kind of helps a little bit. I probably would definitely wear more makeup if I was going to wear this. I'd wear a full face so that I could really bring out the color in the hair and wear more eye makeup so where my eyes are a bit more dramatic than this. But overall, I really like the way it shapes my head. I like the tapered and the curls on the top. I've been looking for one like that. My mommy wig didn't quite do this for me. So anyway, I really like it. So I hope you do too. Talk to you later. Bye.